Miss Ellen with Calvert Library. Welcome to It's Elementary. Today I'm going to read a story about a hippo and a tortoise who become friends. This is actually a true story, and the reason that they became friends is the hippo was washed away during a tsunami. So we're going to learn a little bit about what a tsunami is, and we're going to do an experiment where we create a tsunami in a 2-liter plastic bottle. But first, let's hear our story. It's called A Mama for Owen. It's written by Marion Dane Bauer, and it's illustrated by John Butler. We'd like to thank the publisher, Simon and Schuster, for allowing us to share this story with you today. Let's begin.
Owen was a very young hippo. He lived with his mother, his father, his aunts, and his cousins in the Sabaki River in Africa. Owen loved the river, but even more he loved his great grayish-brown, or was she brownish-gray, mama. Every day Owen and his mama slept together. They swam together, they ate together. Even when mama left the river to graze in the moonlight, Owen followed close behind her stubby tail. Best of all, Owen loved to play hide and seek. Mama hid and Owen found her. And every time he found his mama, he licked her friendly face, laid his head on her broad back, and smiled his great pink smile. But all that was before the rain began to fall. The rain fell and it fell and it fell. The Sabaki River rose and it rose and it rose. The river ran faster and faster and faster. The river rose so high and ran so fast that it washed Owen and his mother and his father and his aunts and his cousins all the way out to sea. Owen roared for his mama, but his mama did not answer. He roared louder. No mama. He searched and searched, but his mama wasn't hiding. She was lost. And Owen was alone in the sea. He roared and roared and roared until finally he lost even his roar. And that was when the great wave came and washed Owen back to shore. Owen was befuddled and weak and very, very sad. He looked all around this new place. This wasn't his river. He looked around some more. Where was his mama? Then Owen saw something brownish gray. Or was it grayish brown? He wasn't sure, but he staggered over and snuggled down next to it. And the very old tortoise, whose name was MZ, lay very still while Owen waited for sleep to come. When Owen woke, he looked again at the tortoise. MZ was colored just like his mama. MZ was large just like his mama. MZ had stayed very close when Owen needed him, just like his mama used to do. Owen laid his head on MZ's broad back and slept some more. Owen and MZ sleep together. They swim together. They eat together. Whenever MZ goes for a walk, moonlight or sunlight, Owen follows close behind his stubby tail. Owen's favorite game is still hide and seek. MZ slips beneath the water and Owen plunges in to find him. MZ nestles in the long grass and Owen peers through the grass until he spots him. MZ rests behind a rock and Owen searches and searches until there is MZ. And whenever MZ takes a nap, tucked away inside his brownish gray, or is it grayish brown, shell, Owen waits and waits and waits until he can find MZ once more. Then when he finds MZ, Owen licks his friendly face, lays his head on the tortoise's broad back, and smiles his great pink smile. Author's note: the story of Owen and a giant tortoise named MZ, which means old man in Swahili, is a true one. Owen was rescued by the Kenya Wildlife Service and local fishermen after the hippopotamus and his family were washed down the Sabaki River by a flood, and he was brought back to shore by a tsunami wave. Owen was less than a year old. Hippopotamus calves ordinarily stay with their mothers for 4 years, and no one can find his mother. So they brought him back to Holler Park, a nature preserve outside of Mombasa. There, the lonely young hippo chose MZ, a 130-year-old male tortoise, to be his mother. And MZ doesn't seem to mind one little bit.
The end. What a great story. Kind of makes me want to create my own tsunami. So we're going to do an experiment using our 2-liter bottle and our pebbles and our water. Gather your supplies and I'll meet you back here in a few. Thanks. Before we dive into our experiment, I want to teach you guys a little bit more about what causes a tsunami. So this first block over here shows a picture of two plates of the Earth's crust. They're called tectonic plates, and these are under the ocean. And what's happening is one plate is sliding underneath of another plate. And when that happens, we have an underwater earthquake, and the energy from these two pressing into each other and one sliding under the other is creating this huge wave of energy that's going to be coming up. So that's the energy blast that's coming up from the underwater earthquake. You can see in the next box, what happens is that energy goes up to the surface of the ocean. Here's sea level, and it pushes the water up, 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 very high, higher than normal sea level. But at the same time that's happening, gravity is still pulling down on the ocean. So what's happening is these two things are combining, the pressure, the energy pushing the water up, and gravity pulling it back down. And when those two things combine, what ends up happening is the energy gets dispersed in these waves. So energy is kind of pushed out horizontally into these waves, and that's when tsunamis happen. So let's go ahead and talk a little bit more about tsunamis. So today we are going to try our own tsunami wave experiment. An experiment, if you haven't done one before, is a way to test something out and answer questions about it. So we're going to test out creating a tsunami wave, and we're going to ask a few questions and see what we find out by recreating it here in the bottle. So when you do an experiment, you often have a hypothesis. Your hypothesis is what you think might happen. So what do you think might happen when we turn this bottle on its side and we're recreating the shoreline and the ocean? And once we give it the blast of energy that I'm going to create with my hand, what do you think might happen to the shore? What do you think might happen to the ocean? Okay, do you have an idea? That is your hypothesis. So next, we're going to actually try it out. We're going to see if our hypothesis was what we thought, if it was true. And we'll learn a little bit about how, you know, kind of actually watching a little mini tsunami wave in action. Let's give it a try. All right, we're ready to do our experiment. We have our empty 2-liter soda bottle filled with about 2 inches worth of small rocks or pebbles. And then on top of that, we've got about 2 cups of water or 16 ounces of water. We're going to gently lay it on its side. And the rocks are going to represent the shoreline where people live. The water is going to represent the ocean. And over here on the end, my hand is going to be lifting up underneath of the lid of the 2-liter bottle. And it's going to be simulating energy blasting up from an earthquake under the ocean. So let's see what's going to happen. Wow. So basically that energy coming from my hand, which we're pretending is the energy from an earthquake, is going to bring big waves up onto the shore, and it's bringing some of our shore back out into the ocean. Can you see that, everyone? So this is what happened with Owen when the tsunami raised up and brought him onto the shore. So this is what happens during a tsunami when people on the shore, their homes or their cars, get washed back out to sea. It's a very powerful ocean event. I don't know about you, but our experiment definitely supported my hypothesis that I came up with. I thought the water was going to wash over the shore, in big waves and bring a lot of the shore back out to the ocean. That's exactly what happened. So I think we did a good job with our experiment today. I really hope you enjoyed it. It's an easy one to do at home. I would like to really give a big thank you to the Southern California Earthquake Center for teaching me the tsunami experiment that we did today. And I would also like to thank Alex Gendler of TED Ed. The tsunami drawings that I did were inspired by his YouTube video called How Tsunamis Work. Thanks for joining me today, and please keep an eye on Calvert Library's social media feeds and our website for more fun programs for the entire family. Bye-bye.